Hello everyone, welcome to the LRDF 50 series by iQuanta. In this series, we'll be solving an exact CAT level set every day till CAT. So let us start with the first set. The question is, 6 persons P1, P2, P3, P4, P5 and P6 each is given a chance to visit 3 countries out of 6 countries, C1, C2, C3, C4, C5 and C6. The following table shows the number of persons who choose a particular country. So in the very first line, we have been given that we have 6 persons. Everyone will be visiting 3 countries out of the 6 countries over here. Now we have a table over here which is showing us the countries and the number of people that are going to those countries or who are visiting those countries. Like C1 is being visited by 3 people, C2 will be visited by 2 people, similarly till say 6. After that, following additional information is given. So the first one is P2 has chosen exactly 1 country which P5 didn't choose. Second one is exactly 2 countries chosen by P1 and P3 are same. P3 and P6 choose the same 3 countries. So basically all these clues, these are regarding the countries that these people are visiting. If you read the questions, first one is which country was definitely visited by P1. So we can only answer this question when we know which country is being visited by which person and how many people. Second one is for how many persons the 3 countries chosen by them can be uniquely determined. So again for this, we need the same information as required in question number 1. For third one, which 2 persons choose to visit C3, we again need the same information. So what we'll do, we'll form a table over here because we have to relate some countries and the people that are visiting them. So we'll draw a table over here in which we'll be writing down the name of countries along the column. We'll write the name of people along the row. Whenever a person will visit a particular country, we'll put a tick on that particular place. If a person is not visiting a particular country, we'll put a cross over there. So let's go to the next slide. We'll draw a table. So let me write down the names of all the countries. We'll have C1, then we'll have C2, C3, C4, C5 and finally C6. We'll write down the names of all the people as well. P1, P2, P3, P4. P5 and P6. Now let me give a tabular structure to this. So this will be our table. Let us read the clues now. We were given that P2 has chosen exactly 1 country which P5 didn't choose. But since we do not know anything about the countries that these people are choosing, P2 and P5, so we cannot put anything into the table using this clue. Let's read the second one. Exactly 2 countries chosen by P1 and P3 are same. But since we do not know which other countries that P1 and P3 are choosing, so we cannot use this. P3 and P6 choose the same 3 countries. So we'll make sure that they choose same 3 countries, but at the moment we do not have any information regarding the countries that P3 and P6 chose. So we'll leave this. Next clue is P6 chose C1 and C5. So this is a direct clue. P6 is choosing C1 and C5. So for P6 and C1, we'll put a tick over here. Then P6 chose C5 as well. So C5 as well. So we have some information in our table using this clue. And P5 didn't choose C4. So P5 is not choosing C4. So P5, C4 will put a cross over here. We also have to use this table as well, where 3 people who are visiting C1. But since we have too many spaces to fill in the row of C1, so we cannot decide which are those 3 people who are visiting C1. But if we look at C4 over here, C4 is being visited by 5 people. Now if we look at the row of C4 here, we already have a cross in the row of C4. That means C4 is not being visited by person P5. So all the remaining 5 persons, that means P1, P2, P3, P4, P6, they all will visit C4. So we'll put a tick. I hope this is clear. As soon as we do this, if we look into the column of P6, we have 3 tick marks. That means P6 has visited 3 countries. And very initially in the set, we were given that everyone is visiting 3 countries. So that means P6 won't be visiting the other 3 countries. So we'll put crosses over here. Then in the second clue here, we were given that P3 and P6 chose the same 3 countries. So if we have the countries visited by P6, we'll have the countries visited by P3 as well. So P3 will also visit C1. Then P3 will visit C4 and P3 will visit C5. So now for P3 as well, we have all the countries that he visited, all 3 countries. So we'll put crosses over here. Now, in this table that we were given information regarding only C1, C2, C3, C4 and C6. We do not know how many people visited country C5. So let's try to find out how many people visited the country C5. We know that we have 6 people. Everyone is visiting 3 countries. So that means in total 18 countries were being visited in all. That means by all the people. So that means number of people that are visiting C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, C6, the sum must be equal to 18. So if we add 3 plus 2, 5, 5 plus 2, 7, 7 plus 5, 12, 12 plus 4, 16. So here we can see that C1, C2, C3, C4, C6, in total, they all are visiting 16 countries. We want to know how many people visited country C5. So let me take it as C5. So total visits must be equal to 18. So that means 16 plus C5 must be equal to 18, which gives me C5 equal to 2. That means 2 people visited C5. So if we check the row of C5, we already have 2 ticks in the row of C5. That means already C5 has been visited by 2 people, P3 and P6. So C5 cannot be visited by any other person. So we'll put crosses. Then in the second clue, we were given that exactly 2 countries chosen by P1 and P3 are same. So we have to make sure that exactly 2 countries which are chosen by P1 and P3, they must be same. So we'll focus upon the columns of P1 and P3 over here. We can see that P1 is also visiting C4 over here and P3 is also visiting C4. Then P3 is visiting C5 as well, but P1 is not visiting C5. Then the third country that is visited by P3, it is over here, which is C1. Now, since we need to make sure that only 2 countries chosen by P1 and P3 must be same, so very clearly they will be C1 and C4. Because the third country which is visited by P3, it is C5 and it is not being visited by P1 over here. So these will be the 2 countries that will be visited by both P1 and P3. Then we have some ticks in the row of C1. So if we find out some information for C1 in the table above, C1 was visited by 3 people and those people are P1, P3 and P6. That means C1 will not be visited by the 3 remaining people. Then as soon as we look into the column of P5 over here, we have 3 crosses. We very clearly know that in every column of these people, we must have 3 ticks. So if we have 3 crosses, we'll have 3 ticks as well. So I'll be putting 3 ticks in the column of P5. Then after that, C6 was visited by 4 people. And if we look at the row of C6, we already have 2 crosses. So that means we'll have 4 ticks in the row of C6. So we'll put ticks all over here. Then if we look at the column of P1 over here, we have 3 ticks, so we'll have 3 crosses. So we'll put crosses over here. We were also given one clue. P2 has chosen exactly 1 country which P5 didn't choose. So this will help us to verify whether we have drawn the table correctly or not. So let's focus upon P2 and P5. So P2 has chosen exactly 1 country that P5 didn't choose. So if we first look at this particular entry of P2, we have a cross over here and we have a cross over here. That means this particular country was not chosen by both P2 and P5. Then we have an empty space over here, but we do not have any information regarding this space. That means we do not have any information regarding P2 and C2. We only know that C2 was visited by 2 people from the table above. So if we put a check mark over here, we can see that C2 is visited by 2 people. If I remove this one from here and if I put a tick over here, now also I can see that C2 is visited by 2 people. So it is quite impossible to determine which were the 2 countries that were visited by C2. So we'll leave this space empty. Similarly, C3 was also visited by 2 people. So if I put a tick over here, then P2 and P5 are the people who are visiting C3. If I remove this tick from here and if I put a tick over here, now the 2 people who are visiting C3, they are P4 and P5. So here also it is impossible to determine who are the 2 people that visited C3. But we were talking about P2 has chosen exactly 1 country which P5 didn't choose. So if we talk about these 2 entries of P2 and P5, we can see that C4 is the country that P2 has chosen and P5 didn't choose. So this is that one country that P2 has chosen and P5 didn't choose. C4 is that country. So that means with this much information, we are satisfying all the clues. That means we'll proceed to answer the question with this much information only. So let's go to the next slide. We'll try to answer the questions. The first question is, which country was definitely visited by P1? So P1 definitely visited C1, C4 and C6. So in the options, we have C5, which is wrong. We have C1, but we can see that we have C4 as well. So we'll choose the fourth option, which is both C1 and C4. Next question is, for how many persons the three countries chosen by them can be uniquely determined? So we'll check only those people in which we have three ticks. So for P1, we have three ticks. For P3, we have three ticks. For P5, we have three ticks. And for P6, we have three ticks. So that means for them, we can uniquely determine all the countries that were visited by them. So there are four such people, which are P1, P3, P5 and P6. Third question is, which two persons chose to visit C3? So C3, we can see that for C3, we have one tick over here. And C3 was visited by only two people from this table over here. So that tick can be here also and here also. So C3 can be visited by P2 and P5 or P4 and P5. So it is impossible to determine because in the options we have P4 and P5 as well, P2 and P5 as well. So we have multiple answers, hence we cannot determine it. Last question is, the three countries that P5 chose to visit are, so they are C2, C3 and C6. So C2, C3, C6, first option will be the correct answer to this question. So this set was basically based on selection. We simply had to follow all the conditions and you can easily arrive at the answer. So I hope the explanation was clear. If there's a doubt, please ask again. Thank you.